Previously on Ready to Die.
Yo, what up? This is Dennis here, and today is September the 3rd, and that means that Drake's Certified Lover Boy has now been out for at least 12 hours. And yeah, the game is in disarray. As you can imagine, one of the most anticipated records of the year. So a really exciting time for rap fans, not forgetting the fact that Mr. Kanye West also dropped his Donda body of work in the last week as well. So a really exciting time in the rap industry, really for all the fans. Because you can love both albums and you can love both artists without having any issues in between. But today, I want to talk about one specific song. I have been listening to Drake's record quite a bit today. And there's a specific song that stands out. If you are a regular Drake listener or Drake fan, you know that he puts out music based on time and locations. So we've got like 5 a.m. in Toronto, 4 p.m. in Calabasas, 6 p.m. in Dallas. Really incredible rap records where he really goes hard, and he raps his ass off, really. And he obviously, is quite frank in a lot of his assessments in some of these songs. So yeah, today the song that we're gonna listen to is directly from CLB, and that is of course 7 a.m. On Bridle Path. This is a song where Drake is not really trying to hide the fact that he's talking about Mr. West himself, and addressing some of the ongoing beef, which is in a lot of ways quite petty and not real as such. And I think Drake really goes quite a bit into that. And what we learn from him is actually an expose into the character, not the creative genius that is Kanye West, but the man, the person inside, the man inside. And some of his motives and why he's behaving this way. So yeah, I'm just gonna be listening to it now, and let's go. CLB time. Hey.
Look, I wish everyone would tell me exactly what they need from me the first second they speak to me. I'm not with all the secrecy, secretly be for me behind closed doors, be playing it peacefully for the streets to see. My nigga have some decency. Don't move like a poop dog. Could at least keep it a buck like answer to Kumo. I made north of the border like Vito Rizzuto. Throwing parties in Miami, they loving us mucho. With the whole ratio, I'm like David Caruso. There's a mass shortage of people giving me kudos. I've been doing this since T-Pain was pouring us new gold. You tell them I run the country, they'll say Trudeau. Poppy and Chulo, gripping Kulo. And I got the flows, niggas steal like boot toes. You boys reaching new lows. Let me take the rap for that cast for the gold shit while you finding all of the loopholes. You niggas move too cold. See the white collection and assume I got time cause of the ruby rose two-tone. I switch it to the one I call R.P. Nipsey cause I swear to God the bezel got 60 of them blue stones. Maybe I'm getting two stone. Cali cut them all before my tombstone. Here lies a nigga that never lied in his new song or any of his old songs. They sing them shits like folk songs. Kumbaya, boombaye. Know the house, stay on me.
Okay, so... Okay, I mean, I'm like 80 seconds in, a minute and 20 seconds. He feels that, he's paid his dues in the game. He's proven himself. He was artist of the decade for Billboard, which basically tracks all the performance of all the music that is released in popular culture. And Drake basically held the 2010s. That's a 10-year turner. That's very long. and it's 2021 now, and he's just dropped CLB, and it really doesn't seem like he's gonna be slowing down in any way. He seems hungry. He's still not taking himself too seriously. He seems to still be having a little bit of fun, which I think is important in any art. And that's something that you can see is lacking a little bit, maybe from Kanye West's side. It doesn't seem to bring him joy anymore, but it almost seems to be, well, the process of him making like a new record or album, it seems to be quite a struggle and a pain, and it ends up, you know, coming across as him just trying to prove a point. You don't have to prove a point as an artist. He's done unbelievable work before. He's, in my opinion, he's peaked at My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy, and no one is doubtful of his genius, and there's absolutely no necessity for him to still prove. The music speaks. Just keep creating, and the music speaks, and that's what Drake has really done quite wonderfully in the last 10 years. Ever since he actually released his first sort of mixtapes, you know, with Room for Improvement, you know, some of those earlier records really showed that this was a guy that had a unique voice and a unique way of telling stories. And on CLB, he continues to do that. Anyone could tell me exactly what they need from me. The first second they speak to me, I'm not with all the secrecy, secretly beefing me behind closed doors, but playing it peacefully for the streets to see. My nigga have some decency. Don't move like a puto. Could at least keep it a buck like Antetokounmpo. I'm made north of the border like Vito Rizzuto. Throwing parties in Miami, they loving us mucho. With the whole ratio, I'm like David Caruso. There's a mass shortage of people giving me kudos. I've been doing this since T-Pain was pouring us Nuvo. You tell